Now, in the previous video, we had a small discussion regarding what are the data types that are present in Java programming language. And we had a discussion regarding that we have data types which are of integer types. The data types that is going to store integer numbers are byte, short, integer, and long. And the data types that are going to store the floating type, they are float as well as double. So in the same way, we have discussed about what are the different kinds of data types where you can store the data in Java programming language. Now, in this video, we will have a discussion regarding the literals and what are the limitations of the data types where these literals are stored. So initially, for example, we are discussing about what exactly is a literal. So as you can see, a literal is represents a constant value which can be assigned to the variable. A constant value which can be assigned to a variable is called as a literal. For example, if I say we have integer x is equal to 10, where this int represents the data type, x represents the name of the variable, and 10 represents the constant value, which is also called as a literal. Now, as you know, this integer int is a reserved keyword. Okay, so int represents a data type as well as it is also a keyword which is reserved by the Java programming language. And here x is a variable, but as well as this x, you can also say it as an identifier. And here this equal to is an assignment statement, and here where I have written 10, or you can say 10 in decimal value, so this represents a constant value, or you can say this represents a literal. Now, this is an integral literal, that means it is an integer number. Now, there are three ways of representing an integral literal in Java. Number one is the decimal value of an integral literal. Second one is the octal value, and third one is your hexadecimal value. So I'll show you what exactly all of them are, because I think you already know what is the difference between an octal number, you already know what is the difference between a hexadecimal number, and you already know what is the difference between a decimal number. So what I'm doing is I'm just specifying what is a decimal literal. So in case, as you know, the decimal literal where the number of digits are allowed is 0 to 9. In octal literal, the number of digits are allowed are 0 to 7. And whereas if I say hexadecimal literal, that means the number of digits that are allowed are 0 to 9. And then we have capital A to capital F. Now, for example, if I say we have this 32 in base 10. Base 10 means it is a decimal integral literal. Integral means it is a decimal integer number. Now, what is the value of this 32? So the value can be calculated like this: 2 into 10 raised to power 0 plus 3 into 10 raised to power 1. That is why we call it as 30 plus 2. That is why we call it as a 32 number. Now, if you write this same 32 number in the form of octal, that is the base is 8. Now, octal number means it is 2 into 10, 8 raised to power 0 plus 3 into 8 raised to power 1, which you say it is 2 plus 24, or you can say this number is representing 36 in decimal. So this 32 with base 8, or you can say this 32 integral with base 8 represents a decimal number which is actually 26. It is not 36, it is 26. In the same way, if I say this 32 is written in hexadecimal, so hexadecimal means it is 2 into 16 raised to power 0 plus 3 into 16 raised to power 1. So if you represent it, it can be written as 2 plus 48, which is actually 50 in decimal. Therefore, if I write 32 in hexadecimal, which is equivalent to number 50 in the decimal, if I write 32 in octal number, which is representing a number 26 in decimal, in the same way, this 32 in decimal is actually, again, this is 32 in decimal. So this is how you represent integer numbers in Java. Now, as you know, there are different kinds of number system. We can have a binary number system, we can have a ternary number system, we can have a quinary number system. In the same way, we can also actually represent the binary number systems also here. So I should also add binary here, that is binary literals, but I'll explain you what exactly is a binary literal with the help of an example. I think it should be added here. So one of the literals here is binary. So in case of binary, the number of digits that are allowed are 0 and 1. So we have only two types of digits, that is 0 and the digit 1. Okay. Now, coming back to the program, so let us take this simple example where we have written example class digimento, and here public static void main string argument. Okay. So this class, everything should be, every method should be inside a class. So everything in Java is always inside a class. Now, the very first thing that I've written here is integer x is equal to 10. So, if I write like this, that means this 10 is a decimal number. So, it is a decimal number, okay? In the second case where you have written int y is equal to 1010, that means this 10 is preceded by a number which is 0. If any number here in Java is started with 0 or we preceded with 0, we say this number is written in octal format. It is written in octal format. But the same way in the third example, as you can see, this 10 is preceded by 0x. So if 0x is there, that means this 10 is written in hexadecimal. This 10 is written in hexadecimal. Okay, hexadecimal. Now, for example, if I print this, this is just a string concatenation here. So I just concatenated the string with the space mark here. So if you print this x, so x is going to print 10. If you print this y, so as you can see, this y is actually representing an octal number. So whenever you are going to print the value of y, it is going to print the decimal number, right? So if you have to convert this value in decimal. So we have 10 with base 8. So it can be written as 0 into 8 raised to power 0 plus 1 into 8 raised to power 1, which can be written as decimal number 8. So this y is going to print 8. But in the same way, this z is actually representing a hexadecimal number. So if I say we have 10 with base 16, so it is 0 into 16 raised to power 0 plus 1 into 16 raised to power 1, which can be written as 16. So in the third case, it is actually representing the number 16. Okay, so the output will be 10, 8 and 16. Now in the same way, because we have written a decimal number, octal number and hexadecimal number, there's one more representation where I represent the literals in binary. So if I write integer a is equal to 0b1101, so if this any of this number is preceded with 0b, or if I write integer b is equal to 0b10, so if this number is preceded by b, that means it is a binary number. So you have to convert this binary number in the form of decimal number. So 10 with base 2 can be written as number 2. So if you are going to print this one, so it is just going to print the number 2. Okay. So again, here we have decimal, octal, hexadecimal as well as binary should also be added. So in binary, and there is no other way to represent integral data types. There is no other way to represent integral data types in Java programming language. Okay. So let us see how these numbers are stored.